Somebody falling asleep, just give them a little holy pinch. Okay? Holy pinch. Now, don't listen. Just pinch. When you twist it, now that's being mean. Just pinch. Don't twist. Just pinch. Amen? I'm just playing. But we're excited for these series that we've been teaching on the power of praise, el poder de la alabanza. Hemos estado enseñando acerca de esto. And we've been talking about how praise, amen, and worship is very controversial in different churches. Muy controversial en la iglesia, en las iglesias. And we've said that churches fight about this. Las iglesias se pelean por estas cosas. In the book of John chapter 4, Jesus met a woman at the well. Dios encontró una mujer, aleluya, en esa noria, la samaritana, the Samaritan woman. And she, you know, she was confused. Ella estaba confundida because she said, you know, some people say to worship on this mountain. People say to worship in that mountain. Ella decía que, alguna gente decía que adoraran en esta montaña o que adoraran en esta otra montaña. And, you know, she's confused because there's so many things and there's so many ways, amen, that people think about worship. Muchas veces mucha gente piensa diferente, aleluya, de cómo adorar. But how many of you in here have gone to another church other than this one before? ¿Cuántos han ido a una iglesia? Que no sea esta. Now, we are a little bit more, I'm not saying that their worship is different. We're just a little bit more crazy. If you just would allow me to say that. We're just a little bit more radical and more crazy. Estamos un poquito más locos, un poquito más radicales. ¿Cuántos dicen amén? Yeah. Amen. But I still don't believe that we have gotten to that place of worship. I still believe that there's still a lot more. Siento que todavía hay más para alabar a Dios. Amen. Are you here with me? Amen. Because listen, I believe that, listen, the angels, the Bible says the angels rejoice when somebody, when one life gives their life to the Lord, the Bible says that the angels rejoice. What we do is we just clap. And the angels rejoice. But the angels have never had an experience like you and I have. Los ángeles nunca han tenido una experiencia como usted y yo la hemos tenido. The angels don't know anything about salvation. You and I do. Los ángeles no saben de la salvación, pero usted y yo sí. The angels don't know what it is to be washed by the blood. You and I do. They have never experienced that. Los ángeles nunca han experimentado eso, pero usted y yo sí lo hemos experimentado. Yet the Bible says that when a sinner gets saved, they rejoice. Are y'all here today? Y'all just listening to the rain. The angels rejoice. Los ángeles, mi hermano, se gozan cuando un perdedor, una gente que está perdida, se entrega al Señor. Aleluya. El ángel es, aleluya, se regocija. Pero nosotros solamente estamos aquí. We don't pay as much as importance to the people that get saved. Amen. And we don't rejoice as much as angels rejoice. Not knowing that we stole. Now we did not steal because they never belonged to him. But we took a life away from Satan and brought it to the kingdom of God. Trajimos una alma perdida a los pies de Jesús. ¿Cuántos dicen amén? Amen. Are you here with me, church? Amen. And it's very important that we understand this. Es muy importante, mi hermano, entender estas cosas. But here is a conflict that we have. Este es un conflicto que tenemos. And you will not have me lie, people of God. But we have a conflict, and this is the conflict. It is very difficult, listen, to be relational and responsible at the same time. A veces es muy dificultoso ser responsable y relacional al mismo tiempo. You might say, what are you talking about, Pastor? In Revelation chapter 3, Jesus told this to the church of Laodicea. Dios le dijo a la iglesia de Laodicea, en Revelaciones capítulo 3, he said this. He said, you do this. You do this, you do this, you do this, you do all these things real good. He said, but I have one thing against you. And he said, you have forgotten your first love. Le dice a la iglesia de la Odisea, el Señor Jesús, haces esto, haces lo otro, y lo haces todo muy bien. Dice, pero tengo una cosa contra ti, que has perdido tu primer amor. Are you here with me, church? And I, sometimes, church, I'm not saying all the time, but sometimes I identify myself as this church. Because I do a whole lot. That sometimes I get drained, that I forget about him. A veces yo me identifico con la iglesia de la Odisea, mi hermano, porque amo mucho, mi hermano, aleluya, y a veces me olvido de él. You know, there was a time in my life back before I became a pastor, amen, here. We pastored our first church, amen, in 2005. En el 2005, pastoreamos nuestra primera iglesia, aleluya. And we pastored that church, and you know, they had gotten, they laid us off, nos habían dejado ir del trabajo. And I said, you know what, I'm just going to go work for the Lord. Voy a trabajar para el Señor. So I decided to, that whole week, I was going to get up like if I was going to work. I was going to get up at 7 o'clock in the morning. I would go to church and work till about 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock, be in there working, fixing stuff. Estaba componiendo cosas. Trabajaba desde las 7 de la mañana hasta las 3 y media, las 4 de la tarde. Aleluya. And I would be going in there working, 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 working. And I've accomplished a lot of the physical stuff. Aleluya. Arreglé bastantes cosas que necesitaban hacer arregladas. And at the end of the week, I was drained. Estaba, mi hermano, bien cansado. I didn't have a lot of strength. Amen. And I remember that as I was sitting in my couch, I think it was on that Friday. Ese viernes estaba sentado en mi sofá. Aleluya. And I was tired. Aleluya. And I was like, I felt like I had accomplished a lot. Me sentí como que había hecho mucho, mi hermano. And I felt excited, but I was happy. But then the Lord said, listen, everything you did was real good. But not one day did you praise me. While you were busy doing stuff for me, you forgot about me. Que cuando hiciste mucho para mí, aleluya, y estabas haciendo mucho para mí, te olvidaste de mí, aleluya. And the Bible says, aleluya, in the book of Matthew chapter 25, that there's going to come a time where Jesus, the Bible says, that many will come to see him saying, Lord, Lord, aleluya, here I am, God says, depart from me, I never what? You worked for me, but you did not know me. Trabajaste para. Listen, some of you go to your job and you work for a big corporation. You work for somebody you ain't never seen. You work for somebody you don't even know who started that business. No sabes quién comenzó ese negocio. No sabes quién es el dueño de eso. But you go daily and you're faithful in that job for somebody you ain't never met before. Are you? Am I preaching to? Listen, are y'all just being quiet because y'all listening or y'all scared of the rain? Are you here with me? Vamos al trabajo y no conocemos al patrón. No conocemos al dueño. Es una corporación muy grande. No conoces, no sabes por quién estás trabajando. Sometimes we get so busy in church working for God that we forget about God. Se nos olvida de Dios. Come on, somebody. You've been doing some stuff, hallelujah. But there's a lot of people, listen to me. There's a lot of people that get busy for God and their cup is running out, hallelujah. Hay mucha gente que está, mi hermano, aleluya, trabajando para Dios, pero mi hermano, aleluya, se está gastando esa relación. They don't have the relationship with the Father the way they used to. That fire is not there. Ese fuego no está ahí. Are you here with me? But I know this, church. It's hard to be responsible and relational at the same time. Yo sé que es duro, mi hermano, ser responsable y ser relacional con el Padre a diario. A veces es duro. Sometimes it's hard. It's hard. But like, let me tell you something. If somebody's going to take all the time praying, who's going to be fixing the stuff that needs to be fixed? Si estamos uno, si estamos orando, cada rato orando, 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 ¿quién va a trabajar? If you're praying and praying and praying and praying, who's going to work? And if you're working and working and working and working, who's going to pray? Si vas a trabajar, a trabajar, a trabajar, ¿quién va a orar, hermano? Are you understanding what I'm trying to tell you today? So what do we have to do? We have to have a balance. Tenemos que tener un balance en nuestra vida, mi hermano. Are you here with me? We have to have a balance. Why? Because people outside need us. And they need us to work, yes, but they also need us to talk to the Father. Necesitan que nosotros, mi hermano, hablemos con el Padre. Necesitan que nosotros, mi hermano, aleluya, nos pongamos a cuentas con el Padre. So many people, amen, they call me, Pastor, can you do this? Pastor, can you pray this? Pastor, can you pray for this? Mondays, listen, Mondays is the day that my wife and I, we take off that day. And sometimes we do more on Mondays than we do all week. A veces hacemos más los lunes que hacemos todos los otros días, mi hermano. Because there's times where I just need a day where I can just listen. I can just step aside and say, I'm just going to get into His presence. Voy a entrar en su presencia. I'm going to turn off the phone. Voy a apagar el teléfono. Voy a dejar esto, aleluya. Why? Because I need to spend time in His presence. Tengo que pasar tiempo en la presencia de Dios. Are you here with me? Some people can say, listen, I spend a lot of time with my children. Well, who's going to wash the dishes? Right? Paso mucho tiempo con mis hijos. Pero ¿quién va a lavar los trastes? You might say, I don't have to work because I have a husband that provides for me. So I can spend an hour or 2 hours in prayer because my husband takes care of me. But what about that single mom that doesn't have a husband, that has to go to two or three jobs to be responsible, but at the same time can't be relational? Esa mamá que tiene que ir a trabajar, esa mamá soltera que no tiene ese esposo que viene a proveer para él. You have to understand, we have to learn how to balance our life in Christ. Saber cómo balancear nuestra vida, mi hermano, en Cristo. Are you understanding what I'm trying to tell you? ¿Está entendiendo lo que le estoy diciendo, mi hermano? We have to listen. We have to understand this. And listen. I know that this city has things that you know, that the only people that can help this city is the church. If I had enough resources and if I had enough people in the church, listen, that would want to work, we can fix a lot of the stuff in this city. Let me say that again. If we had enough resources and enough people that would want to go outside, we can fix the stuff. Hallelujah. If it's hurting, we can go fix it. If it's broken, we can go fix it. Are you here with me today? God has called us. God has called us to this church. And we find, amen, like Mary. You remember Mary and Martha? When Jesus came in, cuando Jesús entró, Mary came in and she sat at his feet. And Martha went to go do what? She went to go, hallelujah, do the dishes. She was out in the kitchen. She was busy for Jesus, but not with Jesus. Martha, María, se vino y se postró a los pies de Jesús cuando Martha andaba limpiando y lavando los trastes. Cuando dicen amén. There was Martha was over there cleaning. But if everybody comes and sits at Jesus' feet, who's going to feed us? Nobody's going to be there to feed. Nadie va a estar ahí para darnos de comer si todos estamos sentados, aleluya, en la presencia de Dios. Are you here with me? And I feel that a lot of the leaders are, they have captured the Martha spirit, that you're busy for him. And it's gone over you and it took a hold of you, but you forgot the Mary one, which is being at his presence. A veces, mi hermano, tomamos el espíritu de Martha, que queremos estar en la presencia de Dios, pero que estamos estar ocupados por Dios, mi hermano, aleluya, pero no dejamos, que no podemos estar en la presencia de Dios. We get so caught up in doing that we become empty. Venemos a hacer algo, mi hermano, y venemos a quedar bien vacíos. And we don't realize, church, this, that my doing has drained my relationship with Jesus. El yo hacer, mi hermano, ha desgastado la relación. Here it is, people of God. Jesus didn't say, Mary chose the best thing. You did not do what you were supposed to do, Martha. This is what Jesus was telling Martha. She said, Martha, you do this first, and then you do that second. Martha, haces primero esto, y luego haces aquello segundo. Listen, let your doing flow out of your being in his presence. Let me say that again. What you do, let it flow out of you being in his presence. Que lo que hagas, hermano, fluya de estar en la presencia de Dios. Because when you come out here and you see a greeter, si usted ve uno que está en la puerta, aleluya, saludando a la gente, you see an usher that has lost his passion, that means that the spirit of Martha has gotten over that person. That means that the spirit of Mary has left. Why? Because they're no longer doing it because of what their experience with God. They're doing it out of, I just want to be here. Are you hearing me? Si me está entendiendo, hermano. And we never want to get to that place. Jesus said, listen, if you spend time in my presence, you'll be joyful doing what you're supposed to do. Are you hearing me? ¿Está aquí conmigo? Si estás en mi presencia, entonces permite que eso fluya para que hagas lo que tengas que hacer. He said, draw your strength, Martha, from my presence. Spend some time with me and then go do the dishes. Don't go do the dishes and talk about Mary, that Mary decided to come and worship me before she went to. Are you here with me? Y'all are very quiet today. We don't want the Martha spirit to grab a hold of us and never have a relationship with him. Are you here with me? So now, I said all of this to go to the book of Luke, chapter 7, verse 36. Lucas, capítulo 7, versículo 36 al 48. Some people have lost the joy of serving God. Mucha gente ha perdido el gozo de servirle a Dios, mi hermano. You've lost the joy, and we've got to get the joy back. We've got to smile again. Somebody say, smile again. Smile again. Come on. Somebody, y'all need to just smile a little bit more. Algunos de ustedes tienen que reír un poquito más, mi hermano. Está aquí conmigo. Are you here with me? So now let's go to Luke chapter 7, verse 36. Lucas capítulo 7, versículo 36. And we're going to start in verse 36, versículo 36. Y'all ready? Then one of the Pharisees asked them to eat with him, and he went to the Pharisee's house and sat down to eat. Amen. Next verse. And behold, a woman in the city who was a sinner. You know her? They didn't put her name, but she says she was a sinner. When she knew that Jesus sat at the table in the Pharisee's house, brought an alabaster flask of fragrant oil. Next verse. And stood at his feet behind him weeping, and she began to wash his feet with her tears and wipe them with her hair of her head, and she kissed his feet and anointed them with fragrance oil. Come on, somebody. Next verse. Now the Pharisees who had invited him said this. He spoke to himself, saying, the Pharisee spoke to himself, he didn't say it out loud, and he said, this man, what man? The one you invited into this place. This man, if he were a prophet, would know who and what manner of woman this is who is touching him, for she is a sinner. Y'all ready? And Jesus answered and said to him, Simon, so we know one of the disciples are. He said, Simon, I have something to say to you. So he said, teacher, say it. Y'all need to be careful when Jesus tells you he's got to say something. Be very careful, because he will talk to you. Amen. Next verse. Siguiente versículo. 42. Verse 42. 42.
That's the next one.
Where am I at?
41.
Oh, 41. There was a certain creditor who had, there was a certain creditor who had two debtors. One owed 500, and there is the other 50. What does it say? And when they had nothing with which to repay, he freely forgave them both. Tell me, therefore, which of them will love him more? Simon answered and said, I suppose the one who he forgave more. And he said to him, you have rightly judged. Verse 44. Then he turned to the woman and said to him, to Simon, do you see this woman? I entered your house, you gave me no water for my feet. But she has washed my feet with her tears and wiped them with the hair of her head. You gave me no kiss, but this woman has not ceased to kiss my feet since the time I came in. You did not anoint my head with oil, but this woman has anointed my feet with fragrance oil. Go to the next verses. Therefore I say to you, her sins, which are many, are forgiven, for she loved much, but to him who little is forgiven, the same loves little. Next verse. Then he said to her, your sins are forgiven. Father, I thank you for this word. In Jesus' name, somebody said, amen and amen. The disciples, when he goes into the Pharisees, they've been walking with Jesus. And they've lost passion. And I feel that a lot of the times, we that have been in church a long time have lost our passion. Aquellos que hemos estado en los caminos del Señor, a veces hemos perdido la pasión. I don't believe we worship God the way we're supposed to worship God. Amen. These Pharisees, amen, they've seen miracles. To them, the miracles are no big deal no more because they've been seen. When you see something repetitive, people of God, when you see something that is repetitive, it becomes normal and it becomes familiar. Se hace familiarizado. People say, oh, he's gone into the city, he's done a couple of miracles, this is what Jesus does. So they become too familiar with Jesus. And I believe that this is where the church is right now. Siento que aquí es donde está la iglesia. Se han familiarizado mucho con Jesús. que no le adoran como debe de ser adorado. We don't worship Jesus the way he's supposed to be worshipped because we can't become so familiar with Jesus. Are you here with me today? I want you to look at somebody and tell them, that's not me. It's very easy, people of God. How many of you have seen, let me see. I guess some of you are older, and I don't mean it like in a bad way, but how many of y'all remember Sesame Street? You remember Sesame Street? Remember when they would put these things in a box? And they say, you got a tractor, you got a mower, you got this. And then they would put an object and say, which one of these things does not belong in here? And you could identify which one did not belong. Usted podía identificar cuál de esos objetos no podían estar en ese cuadro. Ponían tres cosas que se parecían y una que no se parecía. Well, here you have all the holy people in the room. And here's one that does not belong in the room. Tienes a todos los que deben de estar en ese cuarto, pero de repente está una persona que no. So this story here is also kind of like what they did in Sesame Street. Pick the one that does not belong in that room. Of course, we're going to identify the woman in that room. Vamos a identificar esa mujer, aleluya, que está en ese cuarto, que no, aleluya, debe de estar ahí. She's not supposed to be there. She's not supposed to be around Jesus. Why? Because only holy people, according to religious people, only holy people can be around Jesus. Solamente los santos pueden estar alrededor de Jesús, de acuerdo, aleluya, de los religiosos. Amen. There should be a protocol in coming to Jesus. Debe de haber un protocolo, mi hermano. Are you here with me today? Only the people that got their life all together are supposed to come to Jesus. Solamente la gente que tiene todo junto ya son los que vienen a Jesús. Are you here? The people that got their flesh under control. La gente que tiene ha controlado su carne, mi hermano, son los que pueden venir a Jesús. The spiritual people. This woman does not belong in the room. Esta mujer no pertenece en este cuarto. Are y'all understanding what I'm saying? She's not at our level. No está al nivel de nosotros, aleluya. She don't got it all together. And we have a lot of the people, and even the leaders of the church, aún los líderes de la iglesia, and the people that have been with Jesus so long, they come in and they say, Pastor, I don't have to do all that. I got it right today. I got it all packed down. Ya no tengo que hacer. I don't have to jump. I leave it to the broken people. I don't have to dance. I don't have to shout. I leave it to the lost people. No, you have to understand, I need Jesus every day. If I'm a leader, si soy líder, yo necesito a Jesús todo el día, mi hermano. We can never get to the place where we can say, I got it all down pat. Nunca podemos llegar al nivel, mi hermano, de decir, yo lo tengo todo bien ya. Aleluya, bien aguardado. Ya sé qué es lo que hacer. I know what to do already. No, no, you don't know what to do. So now, the challenge, listen, Jesus takes this opportunity to use this woman to teach the people that have been walking with him a lesson. Because they did not recognize him as Jesus anymore. He's one of the buddies. He's one of the people that's been with us now. So Jesus takes this opportunity to teach them something when they should be teaching. Now he uses this woman to teach them. Because for them, listen, their worship unto God is not necessary the way it was before. So this lady doesn't fit in that room. Esa mujer no cabe, mi hermano, aleluya, en ese cuarto. You have to understand this, people of God. There was no other women in the room. She walks into the boys' club. Imagine this woman. Imagínate esta mujer entrando en el lugar donde está Jesús. They were not welcome in this place. Women were not allowed. Those were the customs of the people back then. Eran las costumbres. This is not what God said. These are the customs that a woman cannot be in that same room. Hallelujah. She would have to be tending to the needs. But here comes a woman that breaks all those protocols. She said, you know what? I know I don't belong here. But I'm going to go in here anyways. Yo sé que yo no pertenezco a estar aquí, aleluya. Pero yo voy a entrar aquí en este lugar. Come on, somebody. The Pharisees are there, aleluya. And they're looking at her. Come on. Come on. Somebody say, they're looking. The disciples and the Pharisees, they think they got it all together. They think they know everything about Jesus. Piensan que sabe todo de Jesús. But they don't understand. Pero no entienden. Don't worry about the lights did not go out. It's supposed to happen. La luz no se fue. Es la pregunta. In comes a sinner. Entra una pecadora. And this woman here has been looking for love in all the wrong places. Esta mujer ha buscado amor en muchos lugares. And this woman has been disappointed by men, by so many men. Esa mujer, the scholars say that this woman was a prostitute. Dicen los escolares que esta mujer era una prostituta. And here she is. And she's standing at the door. Because you have to understand what she's about to do. Usted tiene que entender lo que esta mujer va a hacer. Go up a little bit on this. You have to understand. She's standing outside saying, should I go in? Should I go in or should I not? Should I get inside that place? Because I know I'm not going to be welcome in this place. No voy a ser bienvenida en ese lugar. So you have to understand, they're all in a room. Están todos en un lugar sentados. They're sitting at a table. And Jesus is sitting, mind you, they've been walking. Han estado caminando. His feet are dirty. He's sweaty. Está sudado. Sus pies están, aleluya, sucios. And here you got this woman that is walking. And she knows she's not supposed to be there. But in her mind, she only has one thing. En su mente, solamente tiene una cosa. I got to get to Jesus. I have to get to him. Because when he's sitting down, and all the disciples have gone comfortable, todos los discípulos se han, aleluya, vuelto muy cómodos con Jesús, y entra esta mujer. Y viene a hacer algo que nadie de ahí estaba haciendo. They come to do something. She breaks something. Ella rompe, quiebra esa cajita. Now you have to understand that. They said it was her livelihood. She had been working for this. Yes, it wasn't good money. It was dirty money. It doesn't matter. What she did changed the atmosphere. Lo que hizo cambió la atmósfera en este lugar. She went in there. You have to understand that she went in there and she worshiped God in the middle of criticism, en medio de la crítica, en medio del dolor. You got to understand this, church. We have facilitated this place for you to worship, and still sometimes you don't want to worship God. Hemos facilitado este lugar para que adores, pero aún así no le adora. But you got the woman that the Bible says she's a sinner. That's how they identify her. She's a prostitute. And I want to say that maybe some of the people that were in that room might have called her at one time. Quizás le hablaban. Era una prostituta que entró a ese cuarto donde estaban los hombres. Can you just imagine the room and the atmosphere, la atmósfera en la cual esta mujer había entrado con ese dolor? She had pain. She had hurt. She had bitterness in her heart. She had her heart broken by men after men after men. Hombre que le había quebrantado el corazón. Hombre que le había dado. And she got, she's just weeping. And she's just crying before him. Está llorando, está llorando, está llorando. And the disciples are just criticizing her worship because she doesn't belong in the room. Los discípulos criticándola porque ella no pertenece en ese cuarto. Well, that was a good reason. So they're criticizing. Saying, look at her. What is she doing in here? Look at her dress. Look at her high heels. Look at the way she is. She don't belong in here. Ella no pertenece aquí. No deben estar aquí en este lugar. They're criticizing her. If he knew, if he was really a prophet, they've been walking with him. Han estado caminando con él. Now they say, if he was really a prophet, he would know what kind of a woman this is. Not knowing that he didn't come for the ones that are saved, he came to save the ones that were lost. Sin saber que Jesús no vino a los salvos, Jesús vino a salvar los que estaban perdidos. Women like her. So she's now having to worship in a hostile environment. Some of us don't worship when people don't look at us. When people don't shake our hand at us, hallelujah, we decide, well, I'm not going to give God worship. And God's up there saying, what did I do to you? Why aren't you giving me what I deserve? I didn't turn my face on you. I didn't roll my eyes. Now you got the disciples around, hallelujah, looking and turning their eyes around. And they're rolling her eyes at her, not knowing that she's doing something that they should have been doing. Had they been doing what they've been doing, she would have never walked in. Si los discípulos hubieran hecho lo que deberían de haber hecho, esta mujer nunca hubiera entrado. But Jesus took that opportunity to teach them something. You lost your passion. He said, I don't know if some of you, maybe some of you got it all packed down and you know you've never done nothing wrong, but only somebody that's been through some hell. Only somebody who has had their heart broken. Only somebody who has gone through situations would understand the worship that this woman is doing. La adoración que esta mujer estaba haciendo a Jesús. Solamente aquellas personas que conocen. So now they're criticizing her worship, but you know what? You have to understand something. She's embarrassed. Quizás tiene vergüenza, hermano. Because like I said, maybe some of the people in there at one time called her. Quizás gente le habló. But her, listen. The problem with the church is that we come and look at who's worshiping and who's not worshiping. The problem with the church is that we've got our eyes on people. And this woman here, she just came. And her eyes and her vision and her mindset was Jesus. Su mentalidad era Jesús. Su visión era Jesús. She didn't look to see who was in the room. She just kept on walking. Ella nomás entró. And you have got to see this and imagine how the atmosphere changed because of this woman. She came in and he changed everything around. Entró y cambió la atmósfera. She's coming in. And then she lets her hair down. She takes the pins and she lets her hair down to wash his feet with her tears. To wipe his feet with her hair. Para limpiarle los pies con el cabello. And they said this in the customs and back then, that when a woman would let her hair down, that was a sign of a prostitute seducing a man. But she said this in her mind, I let my hair down for so many other men. This one is worthy for me to let my hair down for him. Este vale la pena dejarle, because this love that he's going to give me is greater than any other love I've ever received. El amor de este es mucho más mejor que cualquier otro amor. Church, it's hard to worship in a place where there's no worship. They were not worshiping God. They were sitting down at the table. Familiar. Now here comes the woman. And changes. Esta mujer entra en el cuarto y empieza a cambiar toda la atmósfera donde estaban todos ahí. You've got to see it in your mind. And when you come in here, you're broken and you say, I just got to get to Jesus. She looked at him. She's walking in. She said, I'm not looking at you because you didn't save me. No te miro a ti. You can say whatever you want, but you didn't die on the cross for me. Tú no te moriste en la cruz por mí. Tú no me sanaste. Tú no me liberaste. Tú no me transformaste. I'm looking out to Jesus. Why? Because he's the one that delivered me. He's the one that saved me. He's the one that's going to restore me. El que me va a sanar. El que me va a restaurar. El que me va a liberar. El que me va a sacar de este mugrero. Es Jesús. His name is Jesus. I am breaking my box on you. I am worshiping you. I am giving to you. I'm giving it all to Jesus. Se lo voy a dar a todos. Jesús, porque él me sanó. So she comes and she pours it all. The Bible says, la Biblia dice, that she broke it. She broke it. I need you to grab this. She broke it. Lo quebró, hermano. Why didn't she just grab it and pour it on here? You know why? Write it down. Write the music. Go higher this on my microphone. You want to know why she didn't pour the oil on her? And this is what I feel a lot of the people in the churches do. You're afraid to break it. Tienes miedo quebrantarlo. The reason that she did not pour that is because when you pour, you are still in control of how much comes out to him. Come on, somebody. Cuando tú empiezas a derramar ese aceite, tú determinas cuánto va a caer sobre él. And some of you can lose your dignity. Some of you don't want to pour. You don't want to break it because you're afraid. Because I'm a businessman. I'm a businesswoman. I'm a pastor. I got a title. I'm apostle this. I'm prophet that. I'm pastor this. I'm teacher this. Listen, titles in the presence of God are no good. Los títulos en la presencia de Dios no valen nada, mi hermano. So she said, you know what? I don't want to control what I'm going to give her. Two things about her breaking that. One, you can't control how it comes out when you break it. Usted no puede controlar cómo, if I have a cup of water here, a glass, and I break it, you have no control. You can't say, well, some of it's going to go here, and they're not going to touch here or here. No, it just goes everywhere. And she said, you know what? I've been for many years, I've been controlling, but now I don't want to control it. I just want to break it. And sometimes you just got to let it come out however it comes out. A veces la adoración tiene que salir como tiene que salir. Sometimes the worship has to come out however it comes out. It might be running. It might be laughing. It might be jogging. It might be shouting. It might be this. It might be that. Is it wrong, Pastor? No, because you just broke something and it just spread and however it comes out, como salga, salga. Quebraste el vaso, quebraste el frasco, y como salga, salga. Because you no longer have control of how much you give him. Ya no tienes control. The second thing about breaking the alabaster box was this. Ha. And I hope he gets that free from this. The second thing she said, I no longer have to go back to that. I no longer have to go back to that lifestyle. So I'm going to get rid of the stuff that I held. Because I'm going to give it all to him. And I will no longer go back to that. Because everything I needed and everything that I thought I had and I needed, I found it in him. ¿Por qué quebrantó la caja de alabastre? Número uno, porque dijo, no quiero controlar cómo salga, que salga como salga. Número dos, porque ya no tengo que regresar a la vida antigua. From this day forth, I'm going forward and I'm going to Jesus. You have to understand how she felt. Yes, she was a very bad sinner. But to whom much is forgiven, love it much. Al que mucho ha pecado, o que al que mucho se le ha perdonado, ama mucho. Al que poco se le ha perdonado, ama poco. And I know that there's probably a couple of you in here that say, you know what, I ain't been that bad. I don't need all of that. I'll leave that to the broken people. But I know that there's some broken people here that you know that you need to give God this kind of worship. Esta mujer no le importó. She didn't care. She got to him. And Jesus let it. Why did he stop her? Porque Jesús no la tiene. Our job is to change the atmosphere. That we go, wherever we go in, we are to change the atmosphere. I don't care if they like me. I don't care if they hate me. I don't care if they're talking about me. Listen, go to your house and change the atmosphere in your house. Go to your work and go change the atmosphere at your job. Go wherever you go, change the atmosphere. Cambia la atmósfera. Be like this woman and say, I'm not looking at nobody else because nobody else gave their life for me other than Jesus. No estoy viendo a nadie más porque Jesús es el único. And Jesus sees and seizes this woman and he says, you know what? I'm going to teach these men something. And he tells them, I came in here, you didn't wash my feet, but this woman hasn't ceased from washing my feet with her tears. I need some people to come and wash Jesus' feet. People that know I've been through some stuff. I see some of you crawling into this place. There's some of you that are, you know, you barely made it in here. Quizás algunos de ustedes muy apenas la hicieron este lugar. Maybe you like this woman. But you had a very rough. And this woman knows, listen, I don't come to Jesus because I've been good. I don't come to Jesus because I've done bad. I come to Jesus because of the blood. The blood is the one that gives me access. The blood is the one that cleans me. The blood is the one that cleans her. And you might have it all together, but I still need the blood of Jesus. Yo necesito que la sangre de Jesús obre mi vida. Because as a pastor, listen, I too have some stuff that I've done. And you got all these judgmental people. I wonder if I can just reach your mind. I wonder what you thought about before you got to church today. I wonder what you were thinking about yesterday when nobody was there. Because we're so quick to judge somebody else's worship and praise, not knowing that, listen, before you look at somebody else and judge somebody, look at the pole that you have in your eye, the Bible says. El tronco que tienes en tu ojo antes de que critiques a alguien, aleluya, estás criticando un palillo, una basurita que tiene, pero el tronco que tú tienes en tu ojo antes de que juzgues la adoración de alguien, mírate tú mismo. What were you looking at last night? I bet some of the stuff that you might have done last night or last week, you don't want it on the newspaper or blast it on Facebook. Because we're so quick to judge other people, to put other people blasted on.
Yeah, that's right.
What about you? What about me?
Yeah.
I need Jesus every day. And some of you can identify yourself as this woman. That even though she fell and the people inside the house did not believe that she was worthy to be next to Jesus, but she said, I don't care. I'm here to break protocol. Vengo aquí para quebrar el protocolo. Si ustedes piensan que yo no debo de estar aquí. So here comes this woman and starts coming into Jesus. And she breaks. Y rompe y quebranta la caja de la basura. Do you identify yourself with this woman? ¿Cuántos de ustedes se identifican con esta mujer de alabastre? How many of you identify yourself as this woman? Are you here with me, church? How many of you identify yourself? ¿Cuántos de ustedes, aleluya, se identifican con esta mujer que está aquí? Can I tell you something? She didn't take care of her sin before she came to Jesus. Her sins got taken care of when she met Jesus. Ella no fue, aleluya, y se encargó de sus pecados antes de venir a Jesús. Cuando vino a Jesús, he took care of her sin. Listen, if you just come to Jesus the way you are, he'll take care of that mess. Don't try to get it right and come to Jesus. Come to Jesus and let him get it right for you. Come on, somebody. She knew she was a sinner. Ella sabía. She knew she messed up just like you. You know you messed up. You know you ain't got it all down packed and all together. But this is a church that will let you come in and worship God despite of the hell you've been through. No importando lo que hayas pasado. This is a church that will tell you, come to the feet of Jesus because it is in him that he can change and shift your life around. Jesús puede cambiar tu vida if you just let go of everything and everything that you're holding on to because this was very precious to her. It was her livelihood. You know how long she has been saving? ¿Se sabe cuánto tiempo ha estado guardando aquí en este mes? And to her, being in the presence of Jesus was more, one more. To her, one moment in his presence was worth more than what she was holding in this box. Para ella, un momento en la presencia de Dios era mucho más que lo que traía en esta cajita. I want you to understand that one moment in the presence of God is worth more than anything that you can be holding on to. Today is not about what can God give me. Today is what am I going to bring upon him that has been holding me back. ¿Qué es aquello que me ha estado deteniendo que yo que tenga que quebrantar? Are you here with me, church? Hallelujah. Look at somebody say, I need him. I want to look at somebody and tell them, I just need Jesus. I don't know what you need to do, people of God. I don't know what you have to do to get to this place right here. But I feel that some of you have been broken. Algunos de ustedes han sido quebrantados. You've been judged. Ha sido juzgado. You've been talked about. Oh, now you think you're all holy? Ahora piensas que eres tan santo. Oh, because now you're going to church. Oh, but now because you go up there and you sing, you praise, you think you're all good and you think you're all of that. But you don't understand. What it does to me, no entiendes lo que hace eso para mí. And there's some of you that you maybe you have to crawl your way to this place. There's some of you that maybe you have to come up here. But I'm sick of people that already have it all together. And they give them a worship of, oh, I have it all together. I'm looking for some people that have been broken and say, I don't have it all together, but I know that if I go over there, he can fix me. He can heal me. Él me puede sanar, él me puede liberar. There's some pastors that are not, there's some pastors that are too good to worship the one that gave them life. Hay pastores de mano que son muy buenos ya para ellos, son muy buenos ellos para adorar al Señor. There's some leaders, there's some ushers, there's some greeters. Hay gente que está en la puerta, hay gente que está afuera estacionando carros. Hay ujieres, hay gente, aleluya. There's worship people, aleluya, worship leaders, worship praise team. That sometimes we think we're so good, I don't need him. Ya no lo necesito. Let me tell you something. When you get to that level, that is a very dangerous level to live in. Es un nivel muy peligroso de vivir. When you think that you, all of your accomplishment, todo lo que has ganado este momento, it's not about the plaque on your wall. It's not about the accomplishment. It is about Jesus himself. Amen. Es de Jesús y Jesús solamente. Are you here with me today? This is what I want to say. I know what time it is. You say, ¿qué tiempo es? But I do believe that there's some broken people in this house. Jesus responds to broken hearts. Jesús responde a corazones quebrantados. Maybe some of you have not been hurt that much. Maybe nobody's ever walked out on you. Maybe nobody's ever told you you're not good. Quizás nadie se ha ido de tu vida. Quizás a ti nadie te ha dicho que tú no sirves para nada. Maybe nobody's ever came in and told you you're a piece of trash. Look at you. You're no good. No sirves para nada. Un pedazo de basura. Maybe some of you in here have been beaten and bruised and beaten physically and abused physically and maybe sexually, quizás sexualmente o físicamente ha sido, aleluya, abusado, abusada. And you understand what I'm trying to tell you, like this woman here. The Bible doesn't record or doesn't tell us how many people abused this woman. La Biblia no nos dice cuánta gente la abusó. The Bible doesn't say how many people came in and took advantage of her. But she knew that in her brokenness, there's only one man that can change my life forever. And he's in this room. Solamente hay hombre. Ya quizás ella dijo, solamente hay un hombre que puede sanar mi corazón. Ese hombre está en este cuarto. Ese hombre se llama Jesús. If you got it all together and you've had a marvelous life and ain't nothing happened to you and nobody's ever done anything to you, listen. And you're good. But I want all those people, todos aquellos, the altar is going to be open. I want you to put that song, Never Would Have Made It, we played that song. Let me tell you something. I told you this a couple of weeks. The disciples only saw the outside of her, but never saw her heart and what her heart was crying out to this man named Jesus. Los discípulos vieron solamente lo de afuera de esta mujer, pero ellos no podían ver el corazón de esta mujer. And what her heart had been crying out for years, por años, esta mujer, she was crying out, I need a different kind of love. I need a different kind of response from the man. Maybe there's a man in here that says, I just need a different response. I've been beaten and, but I want those who have been broken. If you've been broken, listen, the altar's open. Come on, just let him. Just let him. Come on, just let him. Listen, if you feel that we've got it, it's gone past your time or whatever, and you say, Pastor, we got to go, that's fine. Listen, that's okay. But I believe that there's people in here that have been broken. I feel that there's people in here that really understand and can identify with, like this woman, with the issue of blood. I feel that there is people in here that can say, you know what, I don't have it all together. I don't think I could ever make it. What is your heart saying to him this morning? ¿Qué es lo que tu corazón le está diciendo al Padre en esta mañana? This woman, her heart was saying, I need a different kind of love. I need a different kind of love. I need a different kind of embrace. Necesito un amor diferente. Necesito un abrazo. Esta mujer, su corazón estaba clamando algo diferente. What is your heart crying out? Listen to this song with this, with your heart, not with your ears. What is your heart saying? Come on. What is your heart saying? Do you identify with this woman? ¿Te identificas con esta mujer? And sometimes it's hostile. Maybe your house. Maybe in your house it's hostile. Maybe your house there's a lot of strife and there's a lot of anger and fight and bitterness and bickering and all this stuff. And it's hard for you to worship God. But you go anyways because you know, I just need Jesus. Come on. Come on, I'm not going to lay hands on you. I'm going to let you pour it all out to him. I'm going to let you pour out what is your heart saying? Can you just pour it out? You've been hurt. You've been abandoned. You've been left. Hallelujah. What is your heart saying? I don't care if they roll their eyes at me. I don't care if he criticizes me. I don't care if you tell me all these things. I don't care. To me, I just want to get to Jesus. It's about Jesus. Come on. Drop every title you have today. Drop every badge you have. I don't care if you're an owner. I don't care if you're a pastor. I don't care if you're a leader. Drop it all at the feet of Jesus. Drop it all at the feet of Jesus. Just tell him, God, I never would have made it. I need you. Nunca lo hubiera podido hacer. Quítate el título de esta mañana. Deja ir el título. Come on. Come on, just let go. Let it go. Let go of your responsibility. Suelta tu responsabilidad en esta mañana. Because it's about him. It's about him. It's about him. Come on, it's about him. Come on, it's about him. Let it go. Let go of all the hurt. Let it go. Just let it go. Stop holding on to the hurt and the pain and the anger and the and everything that is holding you. Just learn to worship God. Just let it go. You've been devalued. They don't see you like they used to see you. They don't love you like they used to love you. Just let it all go. Just let it go. Just let it go. I never thought he was going to treat me this way. I never thought he was going to talk to me this way. I thought this time was going to be a little bit different. Just let it go. Come to Jesus. Just run to Jesus. Come on, just let it all go. Come on, just let it go. Just let it go right now. My God, my God, my God. Come on, just release it. Release it. Let it go this morning. It's between you and God. Let go of the hurt. Anger. Unforgiveness. Let go of that unforgiveness right now. Come on, he's more than able. God is more than able. I just love to encourage myself. God is more than able. You know that. You would never have gotten here had it not been for God. Just let it go. 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 Let it go. Stop holding on to it. Stop holding on to it. Let it go. Let it go. Let it go right now, sister. Let it go. Let it go, let it go, let it go, let it go. 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 Just let it go. There. God's healing. God is healing you right there. Right there. Right there. Right there. Let it go. 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 My God. God. Oh, he's able. You came in here broken, but you're leaving this place completely whole. God is going to heal your heart completely this morning. God is going to heal. You came in here and your heart was broken, just like this woman. You can identify with this woman. How she was talked about. Come on, come on, come on, let it go, 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 let it go. Let it go, 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 let it go. Yes, 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 out, 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 everything that is out, 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 out now. Everything, everything, everything. There's years of anger, years, years of betrayal, of hurt, of pain, of brokenness. But now your heart, out, everything, 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 out, 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 out. Let it all out, let it go, everything. Let it all go, let it all go, let it all go. Yes, 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 yes. God is able. He's not through with you. They might have walked out, they might have left you. You might have had a rough life. Let it go, let it go, let it go, let it go, let it go. Let it go, let it go, let it go. Let it go, let it go, let it go. Now. 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 Just let it all go. Right there. Right there, right there, right there, right there, right there. Right there. Yes. Yes, 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 yes. Come on, somebody. Come on, just help me pray right there where you are. Come on. God is healing right now. 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 God is healing. God is healing. God is healing right there. Right there. Right there. Right there. Right there. Right there. Ah, yes, 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 yes. God is healing. God is healing. You just wanted to get to Jesus. You just crawled your way to Jesus. You knew you needed Jesus. You knew that one touch of God could change your life forever. Heal God, heal God, heal God right now. Right now, right now, right now, right now. Right now, begin to heal right now, God. Our brokenness is healed. Shame is being broken off of your life. Timidity is being broken off of your life. Right there. Let it go. Suéltalo, 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 suéltalo. Let it go, let it go, let it go. Right now, right now, right now, right now. Come on, just let it go right now, right now, right now. Right now, right now. Yeah, you have identified like this. You identify yourself as this woman did. But you just want Jesus. You're tired. All you want is Jesus. All you want is Jesus. All you want is Jesus. I don't care no more. I don't care how it comes out. I just want to break it. I'm tired of having control. I just want to break it. Pour it out. Come on. Some of you need to break that box. Some of you need to break that box right now. 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 Come on. Break it. Break that box right now. Break that box. Now you can freely break that box. You don't have to have control no more about how much you pour. Just break it. Break it. Break it. Break it. Break it. Break it. Just break it. Just break it. Just let it go. Let it be however it is. Let it be however it is. Break it. Break that box. Break that box. Break that box. Break that box. Break it. God, you're worthy. God, you're worthy. God, you're worthy. I was talking about it. I was criticized. Break it. Break it. Break it. God says he's worth. Break it. Yes. Come on. Come on. Come on, break it. Break that box. 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 Come on, we break everything that's been holding you. We break everything that's been holding you. We break everything that's been holding you now in the name of Jesus. Come on. Come on. Come on. Use her now. 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 Yeah. There it is. Come on. There it is. Let it go. Let it go. Let it go. You're being healed right now. Yeah. Right here. Come on. Come on. Come on. Let it go. 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 Woo! Yes. Come on. Let the way maker come. Let him through. Come on, I break whatever's hindering you right now. I break whatever's been hindering. This is the day where we break. Come on, just break it. Let it come out however it comes out. Let it come out however it comes out. Come on. Let the breaker through. Just let him through. Let it just break.